Hi guys, Nicole and Albert here from Relax My Dog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week we've had a good few questions from you guys, so we're going to be answering them. These include why you should spay or neuter your dog, and whether bones are really safe for your dog. We hope you enjoy the video and that it answers a few of your questions. Okay, so the first question I've been asked is from Kelly. And she's asked what it means when a dog licks. Now, there are a few reasons why a dog might be licking you. Sometimes dogs lick in a submissive way. So it will usually be holding himself low with his head low to the ground, his ears back. And this is almost to say that he knows that you're boss. Albert does this when he's naughty. Don't you, Albie?
I can see you.
A dog's saliva contains a healing agent. So dogs will often lick each other's wounds. This is just in an attempt to heal them. Now, sometimes dogs will lick each other in a dominant manner. So for example, a mother will lick her pups, and for the pups, this is their mother displaying leadership. So question number two is from John, who lives in an apartment and who wants to find a dog that is suitable for an apartment. Now, almost any breed can live in an apartment, as long as they're getting enough exercise. We can't stress how important this is. Now, smaller dogs are always going to be better in an apartment because they'll have more space than a bigger breed. We'd suggest something the size of a pug or another small breed like a Bichon Frise. So you just need to make sure that they're getting out of the apartment for a good mix of different exercises. So this is including walking on a leash to your heel and also running around the park. If you just take your dog to run around the park, then they're going to only ever have excited exercise, and this can lead to different anxiety issues once they're back indoors. Okay, question number three is from Sarah. Now, her dog has been barking whenever he's left alone. This is very common in dogs, and we usually refer to it as separation anxiety. Now, there's no surefire way of making a dog bark less. If there was, we wouldn't have any dogs that barked. However, a dog whose instincts are fulfilled is less likely to be barking, and is more likely to feel comfortable whenever you leave him. So you need to make sure that you're feeding him right, you're giving him plenty of exercise and plenty of water. There's three basic needs for a dog. You also need to be giving him firm and calm leadership, and this will make him feel a lot more secure when you do have to leave him. Now, if your dog is suffering from separation anxiety, then it's always very useful to crate train him. Now, I have done a blog about this in the past, so I'll include a link in the description below. The question number four is from Jess, and it's a question that we get asked very regularly. Now, she says that her vet has suggested that her dog get neutered, and she's wondering what the reasons for this are. Now, there are lots of different reasons to neuter your dog. Neutered male dogs are less likely to roam, and this obviously means that they're less likely to go missing, less likely to get into a fight, less likely to get hit by a car. Unneutered dogs will very frequently get frustrated and try to run away. And if that isn't enough, castration significantly reduces the risk of a lot of different diseases. These include prostate diseases and a lot of forms of cancer. For female dogs, spaying is a great choice too. It reduces the risk of certain illnesses, such as infections of the uterus or mammary gland cancer. Spaying also reduces pet overpopulation. There are millions of dogs who are put down every year because of overpopulation. There just simply aren't enough houses to fit them in. Now, our final question is from Hannah. She wants to know whether it's really safe to feed your dog a bone. Now, this is an interesting one, and again, it's a question that we get asked by a lot of you. Unfortunately, bones are not safe for dogs. Now, we all think of dogs and bones just going hand in hand together, but unfortunately, this is just not the case. You could actually be putting your dog at risk by feeding them a bone. Feeding your dog a bone can lead to a number of different illnesses within your dog. It can lead to an unexpected trip to the vets, emergency surgery, or even death sometimes. Now, these illnesses include blockages to the digestive tract. Choking, cuts to the mouth and tonsils, vomiting, diarrhea, and cracked teeth, which can lead to signs of gum disease and even extraction. So we really hope you enjoyed the video and that it answered a few of your questions. If you have any more questions, then we'd love to see them in the comments section below. Similarly, if you have any ideas for next week's video, then please do let us know. If you enjoyed the video, please do give us a big thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please make sure you hit that button. We'll see you again next week. Bye. Say bye, Albie.
Hi guys, Nicole and Albert here again from the Relax My Dog vlog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy related questions. This week we're going to be giving you all of the tips that you need to bathe your dog. We recommend doing this at least once every 3 months. But for some dogs who spend a lot of time outdoors or who have skin conditions, it's important to do this even more frequently. So here's everything that you need to know about bathing and grooming your dog.